Hello student, in last lecture I have explained you about the rotation and torque. What is torque? Consider this is a rod pivoted at this point. If we apply some force like this, then this rod OA will rotate. Now, today I am going to explain you the types of torque or moment of force. Types of torque or moment of force. So there are two types. One is anti-clockwise and second is clockwise. Okay, if we apply some force on a body which is pivoted at some point, then it will rotate in two possible directions. It will rotate in two possible directions. If we apply force in this direction, then body will rotate about this point in anti-clockwise direction. And if we apply some force like this, then body will rotate about this point in clockwise direction. So there are two types of movement of force or torque. One is anti-clockwise movement and second is clockwise movement. The sign convention for anti-clockwise movement, it is positive. We will take the value of anti-clockwise movement positive and we will take clockwise as negative. Okay, always remember. So there are two types of moment of force. One is anti-clockwise, which is taken as positive in calculation, and other is clockwise, which is taken as negative. Now I am going to explain you couple, force couple. In previous discussion, I have explained you when a force is applied on a pivoted body, then it will rotate. The cause of rotation is torque. We have discussed. Okay, when we apply some force on a pivoted body, then it will rotate in anti-clockwise direction or clockwise direction, depends upon the direction of force. So we can say the cause for rotation of any object is torque. In this example, this is a pivoted body at point O and we apply force like this. A single force applied on a pivoted body cannot produce rotation. Always remember, for rotation we need two forces, equal and opposite. Okay, then force couple is defined as two equal and opposite force and having different line of action. Okay, this is called force couple. Two equal and opposite force having different line of actions make a force couple. In this situation, in this example, I have told you now, rotation is produced by only couple. But in this example, only one force is there. This is applied external force. And the second force is directed at pivoted point in opposite direction. This is the reaction of this body on this pivoted point. Okay, so always remember, rotation, you can say rotation is produced by torque, or rotation is produced by a couple. And what is couple? Two equal and opposite forces having different line of actions make a couple. Two equal and opposite forces. Suppose this is a body A and B, and we apply forces, two equivalent forces, equal and opposite forces, like this. This is F and this is also F. These are two equal and opposite forces, but they do not form a couple because they have same line of action. So always remember, a couple is defined as combination of two equal and opposite force having different line of action. In this example, a body A and B, one force is like this and other force is like this. These are two equal forces acting in opposite direction and having different line of action. This force is acting along this line and this force is acting along this line. But in this example, the line of action of both forces are same. So in this example, these forces do not form a couple, but in this example, these forces form a couple. Two equal and opposite forces having different line of action. Now, these are two forces, F and A and B. Suppose this is pivoted point. Now, moment of couple. What is moment of couple? We can take moment of force. What is moment of force? It is torque, F into perpendicular distance. So, as like this, we can take moment of this couple. Moment of couple, or you can say the total moment of forces about axis of rotation. Total moment of forces about axis of rotation. This is the formula is given by value of one force into perpendicular distance between line of action of forces. What is perpendicular distance? In this example, AB. The perpendicular distance between these line of action is AB. Or you can say this AB, couple R. This is couple R. Okay. Moment of force is called torque. So, as we can take moment of force, so as like this, we can take moment of a couple. Moment of couple means the total moment of forces about axis of rotation. This is moment of couple. Total moment of forces about axis of rotation. So always remember the difference between moment of couple and torque. Torque is moment of a single force, and moment of couple means moment of all forces about axis of rotation. Okay, now I am going to explain about the equilibrium. Equilibrium. Equilibrium means, consider this is an object placed on a surface and there are a number of forces acting on this object, and the state of object remains constant. That object is said to be in equilibrium. If a number of forces acting on this object, consider there are various forces acting on this object, F1, F2, F3 and F4. Okay, and object does not change its state, then this object is said to be in equilibrium. So, there are two types of equilibrium. One is equilibrium of rest. Equilibrium of rest and equilibrium of motion, or you can say dynamic equilibrium. Dynamic equilibrium. Okay, there are two types of equilibrium, equilibrium of rest and equilibrium of motion or dynamic equilibrium. Consider, if there are number of force acting on object and object does not change its state of rest, then object is said to be in equilibrium of rest. And if our object is in motion and a number of forces are acting on object which is in motion and it does not change its state of motion, then the equilibrium is said to be dynamic equilibrium or equilibrium of motion. So always remember the condition for equilibrium. What is it? Net force acting on object, net force, total force. Net means total force acting on object. If total force acting on object is zero, then object is said to be in equilibrium. Now principle of movement. Principle of movement. Consider, this is a meter rule AB and it is pivoted at this point. And there are several forces acting on this object. Then what will be the condition for equilibrium of this rod? So a body, a pivoted body, is said to be in equilibrium for rotation, in rotation motion, if anti-clockwise movement, anti-clockwise movement is equal to clockwise movement. Okay, if the moment of these forces, one side of pivoted point, if the moment of these forces will be equal to moment of this force, then this body is said to be in equilibrium of rotation. It is principle of movement. The total anti-clockwise movement must be equal to total clockwise movement. The theory portion of first chapter A part is finished. Now in next video we will do numerical. We will do the exercise of part A. Then read carefully this chapter from your textbook, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me. You can place your doubt in comment section. In next video, we will do some numerical.